Very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 9th Jan. On the front page you have, Trump backs away from further conflict after Iran hits US troops. So this was Iranian attack. It was in retaliation of the American killing of its top general in Iraq. So after that, now we can see Iranian missile strike which happened on bases in Iraq. It did not harm any US troops stationed there. But and the damage was minimal is what President Trump said, but now he has said that he would want to prevent escalation of conflict here. So this is what Trump said. And here you have Ukrainian plane crash in Iran kills all 176 on board. No hint of foul play. So this crash in Iran, the victims are mostly Iranians and Canadians. And Ukraine has, the airline was from Ukraine, so Ukraine has warned against speculation. Because again, if foul play is suspicious here, then it will result in further escalation of tensions between USA and Iran. And below you have cabinet nod for FDI in coal mining. So an ordinance has been promulgated to ease rules as such. So this is to amend two laws to ease mining rules and enable FDI in coal mining. So here you can see it is Mines and Minerals Development and Regulation Act of 1957 and Coal Mine Special Provisions Act of 2015, which have been amended through this ordinance. So here you can see the changes which have been made are mentioned. And here you can see it is the coal minister who says that these changes have been made to achieve production of 1 billion ton of coal by 2023-24, and what changes are made, he says, is end use restrictions have been done away with. Means coal mining, when it is done, then what should be used for? There are, you know, specific provisions with respect to that. So these end use restrictions have been done away with, allowing anyone to participate in the auction of coal blocks. And it says ordinance would strengthen the auction process of mines whose leases are expiring. So there are mines whose leases are expiring on 31st March 2020. These are some of the changes which it says are planned to be made. And he says also that steel industry would get cheaper inputs, leading to an increase in competitiveness. On page 9 you have, regrassing is mandatory after mining, rules Supreme Court. So the Supreme Court has ordered that mining leaseholders should be held responsible for regrassing mined areas so that biodiversity gets a second chance in this scarred landscapes. So government has also been asked to file a report on this in 3 weeks. The cost of regrassing in the area, it is said, should be borne entirely by the license holder. And here you have, 2019 was the 7th warmest year since 1901. So Indian Meteorological Department has hinted at global warming raising average temperatures now. And this is plea in Supreme Court on minority institutions appointment. So, Chief Justice of India, S.A. Bobde, has agreed to examine on this plea that when the Supreme Court actually has declared in its judgment on Jan 6 that state is well within its right to regulate appointment of teachers to minority-run institutions in national interest. So, there is a petition to re-examine this. So, Supreme Court has agreed to look into it. On op-ed page, you have, on editorial page you have, from the brink of war. So this is regarding US-Iran standoff. So now US President Donald Trump has stepped down after Iran's retaliatory strike on US bases in Iraq. And here you have reality check. So this is regarding misplaced optimism which needs to cede ground to tangible policy interventions. So government is still optimistic that it is a cyclical process, there are no structural changes required and the economy will come back on top, so GDP will improve. So this is misplaced optimism is what this article is saying, and the editorial says that the government needs to cede ground to tangible policy interventions. So policy interventions which will give results, so those are required, as we have seen quite often how even the Nobel Prize winner, Mr. Banerjee, Abhijit Banerjee has also quite often said how government needs to intervene, putting money in the hands of the poor. Then this is the lead article, A Multilateral Alternative by Asia. So this article talks of the phrase Asian century. So this phrase came up in 1980s, around 1988. So this was when Chinese leader Deng Xiaoping and former Indian Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi re-established relations, and it was called Asian century. So now a new order with India and China as key players is required, and it should not be seen through Western prism is what this article is saying. So we need multilateral organizations which US, India and China lead, where Western countries may not be, it should not be from their perspective. So this is a multilateral organization which has been like a new framework which is required, has been proposed here. The article also speaks of the potential of Belt and Road Initiative, the infrastructure project which China has proposed. So how it can also become a multilateral, come under a multilateral framework. And here you have betrayals from outside and within. So this talks about Muslims around the world, how they are being pushed to the wall, but they must avoid the Islamist trap. So, Muslims are being targeted, and as a response to that, then Muslims, get into that Islamist idea. So, this is betrayal which is happening from outside and within. Means people are targeting Muslims, and then Muslims within are being getting entangled into this Islamist trap of jihad and terrorism. So this vicious cycle should end. And then on the op-ed page you have the Indian Constitution's unitary tilt. So this talks about center-state conflict over Citizenship Amendment Act. It says in some places this may lead to a fresh debate on federal question. So some states we have seen already, they have refused to implement NRC as such and CA in their states. And this is, it is high time the National Defense University takes off. So this is proposing a National Defense University, which says education reform is long overdue in the Indian military. And this talks about protests. It says the age of agitations. So youth-led protests across the world provide a refreshing throwback to the 1968 movements. So how youth protested. So similarly, we are seeing youths protesting in various countries, including Hong Kong, in India, in Chile, Catalonia, etc. On page 12, you have Modi meets CEOs for feedback. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi has sought opinion of CEOs of important industry leaders, and he has asked them how about feedback on how to tackle sector specific and macroeconomic issues affecting the economy. And this is revised norms for data-led probes. So the Union Home Minister said that before seeking information about person's email account hosted on servers in foreign countries, investigating agencies will have to establish that it is linked to a crime. So this is regarding data protection as such. So this is, and here you have this is 5,559 crore rupees to set up Northeast gas grid. So it is the only second instance of the government directly funding a gas pipeline, and Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has approved this viability gap funding for the proposed Northeast gas grid. So it will be 1,656 kilometer Northeast natural gas pipeline grid, which will connect Guwahati in Assam to major cities in the regions, such as Itanagar, capital of Arunachal Pradesh, Dimapur, Kohima of Nagaland, Imphal, Aizawl, Agartala, Shillong, Silchar, etc. And this is team of 17 envoys to visit Kashmir. So we had seen earlier how government had said that it will allow envoys in Delhi, foreign envoys in Delhi who are stationed as ambassadors to India. So they would be allowed to visit Kashmir. So ambassadors of European countries have rejected this invitation. They seek freedom to meet people. But 17 envoys have been decided who would be visiting Kashmir now. On international page you have, we will end US presence in West Asia. This is what Iran has said. Iran's supreme leader Ayatollah Al-Khamenei has said that strikes launched by Iran are a slap in the face of America. So this is the strike on Iran. In Iran, strike on US bases in Iraq. Here you can see this is a satellite image which is showing the damage caused by the missile, this Ain al Assad air base in Iraq. And this is a news analysis on US Iran conflict, what would happen next. Though US President Donald Trump has called for de escalation, but risks remain. Then on business page you have mutual funds asset base slips 2% in December. So liquid funds witness pullout of over 71,000 crores and equity funds see net infusion of 4,432 crores. So this is how mutual funds asset base has slipped. And then you have, this is telco seek open court hearing on AGR, that is adjusted gross revenue. So they urge Supreme Court to rethink on its verdict upholding the recovery of 1.47 lakh crores from telecom companies which are due to the government as past dues. So now they are calling for a rethink on this, means appealing on this verdict of Supreme Court, asking for an open court hearing. Then below you have Carlos Ghosn hits out at Nissan and Japan. So this is Carlos Ghosn, who is former boss of Nissan Group of automakers. So he was the at the helm of automaker Nissan, but then Japan initiated, it's a Japanese company, Japan initiated trial against him. So this was on charges of underreporting earnings, breach of trust and misappropriation of company funds. But he denies all these charges and he escaped from Japan. So now he has appeared and spoken about it. He says charges against me are baseless. And he repeated his allegations against the government, saying that Nissan and Japanese authorities colluded to oust him. So Nissan Group also wanted him out of the top job. And Japanese authorities helped them. And this is because of downturn in Nissan's fortunes and in revenge for French government interference in carmakers' alliance with Renault. So that is, Nissan had made an alliance with Renault. So French government was intervening. So that was not to the liking of Nissan Group and Japan. So that's why he was being targeted, is what he says. So that is it. These are the important headlines. This is again regarding budget. So budgeting process would start. And rising oil prices, how it is a concern, because India imports more than 85% of its crude oil requirements. If oil prices are high, then outgo in the budget would also be high. So that is there. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asha.com. Thank you.